the game, cause see the boxing boys. Welcome back, gang, for the first time and hopefully many more to come. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel and click on the notifications right here, this little bell, so you can get those emails every time we go live.
BoxingBoys.com.
What broke him down? Was it just the
body punching?
I was hitting him with body punching. I heard him, actually, he was crying in there. You're saying that Biggs was crying when you hit him?
Yes.
When did that happen? And perhaps the fourth round on.
BoxingBoys.com.
So you knew you had him by that
Absolutely.
Time?
Absolutely, but I knew he was tough and you were taking those punches.
Yes, yes. What is up, TBV family? I hope you all having a good Tuesday. Good Tuesday morning. It is 11 a.m. at the recording of this Pacific Standard Time show. But we're just going to do a quick breaking news show. Obviously, it was breaking news yesterday, but we did not have time to deal with it yesterday for a show or anything like that. So I want to at least delve into the breaking news of Manny Pacquiao versus Lucas Matisse, official for July 14th in Malaysia. And for those that don't like the fight, cover both sides there, both sides. Obviously, this is not news. I mean, there's been rumblings of this forever. Manny Pacquiao has basically said that this is the next fight. We've heard rumors of a split with Top Rank. We've heard of all these instances, and some of them are true. Some of them are half true. And I definitely can't wait to delve into it and see what is up. But first, let's go to the actual breaking news itself. Mr. Oscar De La Hoya, CEO, or is he CEO, owner, president, whatever official title he is of Golden Boy, founder, whatever, signed, sealed, and delivered, proud to officially announce that WBA welterweight world champion at Matisse Lucas will put his title on the line against at Manny Pacquiao in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, on Saturday night, July 14th, U.S. time. Wow. And but before we go to the next one, I'm just going to say this. I hope I pronounced that right. For anyone in Malaysia or that knows the language over there, please let me know if I fucked that up. I'm not that surprised that this happened. I'm kind of surprised that it was announced in this manner. But obviously, as we're going to get into with Dan Rayfield's article on ESPN and some obviously quotes from both Manny Pacquiao and Michael Kuntz, his manager, I'm not surprised we're hearing it from Oscar instead of Bob. I know. But let's go to Manny Pacquiao's tweet. It's on. Can't wait to challenge Lucas Matisse for another world title on July 15th. Obviously, that is in that, you know, local time. In Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, July 14th, U.S. time. Hashtag Pac-Man is back. And I'll be honest, like, I'm not, like, the biggest Pac-Man fan. I also think that he's probably way past his prime. He is nearing the point where I'm worried about a Roy Jones effect. Obviously, this fight's going to be a huge determination of that. But yeah, I mean, at least he's excited. This is a more, you know, higher fight. I mean, what's the term? It's a more established, more relevant fight in the division than, let's say, Mike Alvarado. You know, Enrique was talking about it when we were doing shows on it months ago about how, you know, he's just not interested in Mike Alvarado. And me, you know, thinking as more of a hardcore, putting on that promoter hat, I thought Alvarado was the perfect matchup for Pacquiao. I think Matisse is a little bit of a dangerous a foe for Pacquiao at this point in his career. But let's delve into Dan Rayfield's article specifically, because there's some very interesting things here that I think it's just important to make note of. Obviously, right here, let me highlight it for you. Let me scroll down a little bit. There you go. Manny Pacquiao would not be trained by Freddie Roach. Obviously, that was basically confirmed by multiple sources in both camps that Freddie Roach and Manny Pacquiao had this huge split. They're no longer on speaking terms with each other for whatever reason. It's unfortunately very sad. Hopefully, something can be done about that. But that is, to me, a point of concern, a point of I don't know what version of Manny Pacquiao we're going to get. Obviously, his second boy, Fernandez, will be his lead trainer for this one. Now, this one to me is probably the most significant. Although this fight will be on ESPN in some fashion, it will not be promoted by Tom Frank. And whoa, hold on a minute. I know. And I really don't know what to make of this other than, wow. The rumors of a promotional split, a legal split from Bob Arum in some fashion, seems to at least be relevant. That there is some smoke to, there's some fire to the smoke, so to speak. I don't know the degree of it, because obviously Bob Arum's company, Top Rank, will handle the television distribution of the fight in the U.S., but he's not promoting the fight. That, to me, is highly interesting. I wish I could, you know, speak to Michael Kuntz more about it and sort of realize what is there. You know, obviously, he may not tell me, but hey, it is interesting to make note that for all those people, all the rumors out there that Manny Pacquiao was trying to get away from Bob Arum promotionally, it is true. Because Bob Arum is not promoting his next fight. He's only dealing with the television distribution in the U.S. So, I mean, is he a top-ranked fighter? And actually, Manny Pacquiao went on in that article, please go check it out, talking about how the next fight in the fall, he wants Lomachenko. You know, maybe, I don't know what to make of this. There's a lot of different narratives, a lot of different talking points, a lot of different angles to take on this matchup. So, highly interesting to me. I really don't know who will win this one yet. I think I'm reserved the right to make a prediction yet. But let me know what you think in the matchup. Do you buy or sell this fight? Are you hyped for this? Do you think Pacquiao's maybe biting off a little more than he can chew at this point in his career, coming off a loss to Jeff Horn? Or is Matisse also, you know, faded good, so to speak, and Pacquiao, being the legend he is, should be able to beat and outbox Lucas Matisse, who even his last fight did not look that great until you got the knockout. Definitely leave a comment. Hit that like button. Tell me what you think about our new Facebook Live show that we did yesterday. Go check that out. We're going to try to be doing that more as we move forward and as this, you know, YouTube Live ban is in effect. Make sure you go to patreon.com/theboxingvoice to help support your favorite show and get hours and hours of extra content. And, of course, find me at Mixed Combat News on Twitter, Mahano TVB on Instagram. It's been a good one. We should be back later with the show. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but we should be back later. Should be fun. Should be lit. What is up, TBV family? Yes, YouTube has been cutting funding to their channels as of late, and with net neutrality going through its process, the internet is changing. If you want to keep your favorite channel intact, coming up with tons of content, and plus get hours and hours of extra content, head over to patreon.com/theboxingvoice to become a member of the TBV family and help support the channel. Peace. Ain't no other sight in the game to see the boxing voice.